AV Flotilla has arrived in Cuba for the first time since the fall of the Soviet Union. The destroyer Admiral Chibanenko and two support vessels have moored in Havana and will stay there until Tuesday. This is the final stop by the squadron in its Caribbean tour. RT's Mikhail Lebedev reports now on what has become a historic voyage.
It's a long time since Russian ships had such a welcome. There hasn't been a Russian warship in Havana Harbor since Soviet times. The visit is viewed as the latest sign of renaissance in relations between Moscow and Havana, which cooled dramatically with the collapse of the USSR in 1991.
Russia is re-establishing ties with its old friends, and it seems that this time returns not on ideological base. The Russian return would be based, of course, on market and economic interests.
The destroyer Admiral Chibanenko, along with the nuclear-powered cruiser Peter the Great and support ships, arrived in the Caribbean last month. They held joint exercises with Venezuelan Navy, and then Admiral Chibanenko became the first Russian warship to sail through the Panama Canal since the World War II. This naval marathon is widely seen as a message of renewed strength from Kremlin to the White House. But Cuba may not be easily wooed.
I would think that the Cuban government might be hesitant about appearing too closely tied to Russia for fear that that might react negatively in what people expect to be some kind of diplomatic initiative by the new Obama administration towards Cuba.
The ship's arrival in the region coincided with a Latin American tour by the Russian President Dmitry Medvedev, who raised the country's profile on the continent in several meetings with his counterparts. He also enjoyed a warm welcome from the Cuban leader Raul Castro, seeking to boost relations. And the visit of the Russian ships could be the first step.
Russia is looking for, in the region, for those who are ready to think and act independently in the world. And indirectly, it is also a sign to the United States that we have access and good debates in your backyard.
And the voyage of the Russian flotilla has been more than just flying the flag. They've brought tons of medicines and other humanitarian aid to Nicaragua, and a deal of goodwill which can't be measured. Mikhail Lebedev, RT, Moscow.